give you honor.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
I wanna see your glory. crying and the shouting and the laying before me and the been wondering of why. Why has this happened? Why has that happened? None of this took me by surprise. He didn't go unnoticed. I've been listening to you. I've been hearing you. And I've been working on it. I've been working on sending you the answer. And this morning, as you cry out to me, as you worship to me this morning, I am laying it in. I am laying it on. I am building. For I'm building something, says the Lord, in you. I'm building something in you. I am increasing your faith. Your faith is being increased. Because of the time and the times that are upon you now, an increase of faith must come forth. And I am listening. I am hearing. And I am sending angels out to bring in the harvest of prayers to you. For it is harvest time upon you. The harvest time is upon you. And the gathering of the harvest has begun. The gathering of the prayers, the gathering of the unanswered prayers have not begun. And now I can say to you, your harvest is near. Your harvest is here. Let the harvest begin. For I am the Lord of the harvest. I am the Lord of the harvest. And your harvest is coming. Be assured, your harvest is coming. Your harvest is here. Your harvest is coming, and your harvest is here. You may say to yourself, harvest coming, harvest here. For some, harvest is coming. For you have not reached that place yet of harvest is here. But for some, harvest is here. Harvest is here. So reach out and take it. Reach out and receive your harvest this day. For the heavens is wide open, and the harvest is being poured out. The harvest is being brought to you. So right where you're sitting, right where you're standing, begin to praise me. For I said my word, I'm not a man that I should lie. Watch you pray for according to my word. I have heard and I have delivered. So now's the day to receive. Believe that you receive. Believe that you receive. What have you been believing for? Then receive. What have you been believing for? Then receive. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's let that sink in right now. I just, what I heard was, this. The windows of heaven are open. 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 In the name of Jesus. the name of Jesus. Lord, as I speak directly to you, and I say, be healed in the name of Jesus.
And the enemy's going to try to put thoughts in your head.
See, the enemy's going to speak to kids just like little adults. If he can stop them at, if he can stop them if they're children, then he can stop the whole plan of God. Just like when I was in high school. Children, line up down here for me, please. Teenagers, children, line up over there for me, please. I want Minister Caleb first. But I plead the blood of Jesus over you, Caleb, right now. And as your parents plead the blood of Jesus, and pray over you, your grandparents plead the blood of Jesus. You are an oracle of the Lord. Your voice carries weight. And it's not just because it's your voice, but it's because the anointing in your life. And you're going to take it not only to your school, not only to your city, but Kaylee, I say this, and I say unto the Holy Ghost, your voice, and I'm careful what I say, but your voice is going to be heard around the world. I don't know how, but your voice is going to be heard around the world in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Show your glory. And let her see every word come to pass. I'm anointing you this morning in the name of Jesus. I charge you in Jesus' name to take it to your generation. Take the word of God to your generation in the name of Jesus. Now as you stand here, I plead the blood of Jesus over you. I plead the blood of Jesus over your minds. You were raised up to serve the Almighty God. You were raised up to serve the Lord Jesus Christ and not the world. And I bind any influence of the world over your life right now. In the name of Jesus. Any thoughts, anything you see on TV, anything you hear, that's not of God. You'll know in your spirit, you'll know. As a matter of fact, God will begin starting today. God's going to reveal to you when something's not of Him. And you're going to know it. It's going to be your opportunity to turn it off and say, I'm not listening to that. That's not my Heavenly Father. I'm a child of the King. And I know my Father's voice. And that voice that I'm hearing is telling me to do something wrong. That is not the voice of the Father. I'm not going to listen to it. I'm going to take the word of God to my generation. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, all. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. 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 the name of Jesus. My God, I can't tell them I see you. Don't worry about what people think. Don't worry. Should I, could I, would I? Do it!
Yeah.
Do it!
Yeah. Glory!
She said, I heard you say you went to church occasionally. Does that mean your pastor preaches occasionally? That's what happens to us in our confession. I was sitting there and God began to mention to me about our confession. He said, and he said, you know, that's what people do with their confession a lot of times. What they're believing for. They do it occasionally. But it's something that has to be done every day. It's just like when Dr. Hagin was laying in that bed sick. We watched Mark Hagin's last Sunday night. And when Dr. Hagin was laying in that bed and everybody was telling him he was going to die, that he wasn't going to make it, all of a sudden he just began quoting the Word of God. And he said, devil, you're a liar. Now he said, I didn't feel like laughing, but I made myself laugh. That's where we get our ha, 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 ha. Laugh at your situation. Then he came up with the phrase, well, then you fake it till you make it, praise God. What do you mean by that? Fake it till you make it, baby. That means whether you feel like making it or not, whether you feel like laughing or not, make yourself laugh. Keep laughing. Until finally he said, I just started going, ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Until finally, all of a sudden, the joy of the Lord took over. And I forgot how many days he just kept laughing in the Holy Ghost. But it started out having to make yourself laugh. We got to make yourself. Even when you don't feel like confessing the Word of God, make yourself confess the Word of God. Watch what's coming out of our mouths. Watch what we're saying. Are we saying the Word of God? Are we believing the Word of God? This is important. I'm telling you, this is so important in these last days. We want to get what we need from God. And it's not some magic potion or nothing like that. It's getting you, what God's doing is getting you on the area of faith where you just know it. That's why you keep saying it till you finally, it's not just, because some people move in the area of hope, like I'm hoping it works. Hope. Oh, see, that's not it. He's getting you over in the air. He wants you to get over the air where you know. But even though, that's why we say when we do our Bible confession, this is my Bible. I believe what it says. No matter what people say, no matter what my circumstance says, no matter what the devil says, I'm a believer. Therefore, I am a receiver. I do believe that I will receive absolutely everything that God has for me today. Say it every day. Whether you feel like it or not. You praise Him every day. Whether you feel like it or not. You shout, I'm healed. I'm healed. Whether you feel like it or not. Don't let words of doubt and unbelief come out of your mouth. What we got to get to is get the point of where we get a grip on our lip. Get a grip on our lip. Get a grip of what we're saying. Get a grip on what are we believing. Amen. That's a place, that's why He gave you this. Man, this is a grace this morning. Grace this morning. Hallelujah. Hebrews 13:5 says, by Him therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually. Notice it with a part-time work. Continually. That is the fruit of our lips giving thanks to His name. Word thanks is a same great word meaning confess and acknowledge. Your faith lives and flourishes as your mouth is continually filled with praise. That praise is private but must be public also. In fact, Jesus said, whoever shall confess me before men, him will I confess before my Father which is in heaven. Every time you speak the Lordship of Christ to another person, Jesus will confess you before the Father. Glory to God. Hebrews 10:23 says, so let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering. For he is faithful that promised. The Message Bible says this, let's keep a firm grip on the promises that keep us going. He always keeps his word. He always keeps his word. Listen to me. He always keeps his word. Thank you. Praise you, Jesus. So I want us just to all, everybody this morning, just lift your hands to him this morning. Praise God. Offer praise. Offer thanks to him right now. Just begin to thank him. Begin to praise him this morning. Begin to lift him up. Oh, we bless you, Lord. Oh, we bless your name.
Yeah.
I'm just going to receive this morning's tithes and offerings. The altar is open. And I want you just to bring your tithes and your offerings to Him in worship, in praise today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We worship you, Lord. We thank you, Father. Now, what belongs to you. We don't keep, we don't hold back. Lord, in my household, we're not going to be known as a robber. I'm going to be known as a worshiper, a tither, and a giver.
Patrol, you ain't got no weapons.
And they say, okay, there's a mass shooting going over here. Go over there. And we're not giving you a vest. We're not giving you a weapon. Just go over there. That's how Christians are today. They got no armor. They got no power. They got no authority. That's why most Christians are spiritually getting killed today. Because they don't have no authority. They carry no power. All they are is lip service. That's why you need the Holy Ghost. That's why we need the Holy Ghost. You need Him in all His fullness. Not just part of God. You need all of God inside you today. So I thank you this morning, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, we receive your fullness.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, we receive your fullness. I praise you, Lord. I praise you, Lord. Lord, you are good, and your mercy endures forever.
Lord, Karen, I don't want to withhold any good thing.
their pastors today. And I thank you, Lord, you are paving the way and you're making the way for Karen and I to be here for them. We stand strong in it. We will stand and see the salvation of our God. Karen and I are going to be full-time pastors for this congregation.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
And I thank you for it, Lord. Oh, praise you. So good.
I want to tell you a little bit about God we serve and the Spirit that's living in us. And this is a testimony from a young man that's in prison. Out there this past Wednesday night, he gave this testimony. Wednesday before last, when we got ready to leave, we called for Pastor called for anyone that needed healing or prayer. This young man comes up and he said, I can't hear. He said, I haven't been able to hear for about a week since my head stopped up. My ears are stopped up completely. They've given me some drops to put in them, but it hadn't been effective. And he said, I need prayer because he said, I need to hear what's going on because he's got a very precarious job. He's in a welding class right now and has to weld. And he has to do what he's supposed to do and do it correctly. So he came up and we prayed for him. We laid our hands on him. And we believed for that he was healed. He goes back to his dorm and he gets ready to go to bed and he puts some drops, a couple of drops in each ear. He lays down on the bed. They put him 3 bunks high in this dorm. He had to climb up to the 3rd bunk. You know, and he's up about as high as this metal bar right here. And he's laying on this bed and he's laying on this bed all of a sudden. Popping, cracking, explosions like coming inside his head.
Yeah.
And he said, oh my God, my healing is coming upon me.
Yeah.
And he grabbed his head and he said, it's just going off, just like firecrackers going off inside of his head.
Yeah.
And he said, he pulled the cover up over his head where nobody would see him or hear him. He said he went to praising God there on that top bunk and laying there and thanking him for what was happening to him. And the explosions just kept on going and it was going off in both ears just like firecrackers exploding. And he was laying under the cover and he was moving around and just praising God and thanking him for his healing. He said, I've got my healing. His hearing at that moment was completely restored.
Yeah.
And he come in that night, last Wednesday night, just praising God. That's how good he is. To a prisoner that's in a prison, he's been in, out there for several years, and he was praising God, thanking him for that healing. And I'm going to tell you something. What we've done here this morning, he can do that same thing for you. Start to hear an explosion going off in your head or in your heart because it's going to be there if you take hold of it. Let me tell you something, folks. It's the season for Jesus to come back. All you got to do is just look around you and see what's going on. It's the season. He said, you know the season. It is the season right now. And it's coming. And let me tell you, the closer we get to his coming, the faster these things are going to occur.
Amen.
So look out for them. The fields are ripe for harvest right now. We've already had one man this morning that led him into Jesus this week. Man, I just praise God for that. I just thank, praise Him. Man, I lift up the name of Jesus because, you know, there's been one more saint that's been added to the list in heaven. Hallelujah. This is thanking and praising. Hallelujah.
Lord of God. Hallelujah. Love you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now just let Him rest on you. That's what's happening right now. He's blanketing you with His anointing. Blanketing you with His love. I know this sounds like it gets old, but see, I know what I'm talking about because I've been here hundreds of times. Breathe Him in, Lord God. Breathe Him in. You need your sinuses cleared. The anointing will take care of it right now. Breathe in the anointing. Sickness in your body, breathe in that anointing. That burden removing, yoke destroying, power of God. Thank you, Lord. And here's the key. God can't make you receive. I can't make you receive. Your friends can't make you receive. It's a personal choice. It's up to you. Do I want to stay the way I am or do I want to change? It's up to you. I choose to change. I choose to go up higher. I choose to go to the next level. We'll get into this when we start teaching the believing authority. You know you've been risen, you've been raised with Him. You've been raised with Him. We are seated with Him. It's time for people to come on up. Instead of staying down, it's time for you to come up. It's time for you to move up to the high places, into the high things of God. I'm not going to stay the same. I don't want to stay the same. I want to move up into the high things of God. So just take a moment. Let Him rest upon you here. Let that sweet Spirit minister to you. Hey, we're going out of here full of the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Thank you. If I came in here sick this morning, I ain't walking out sick. If I come in here broke this morning, I ain't walking out broke. If I come in depressed this morning, I ain't walking out depressed. If I come in oppressed, I ain't walking out oppressed. I'm going to walk out in the fullness of the joy of the Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you. You're good. Oh, Lord, you're so good. Thank you for this time. Thank you for this service. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for making habitation with us today. I believe with all my heart, we are the sanctuary of the glory of the Lord. Welcome you here. Holy Spirit, we welcome you here.
Amen.
We're not ashamed of you. we love you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Oh, glory to God.
You can sit and soak for a few minutes if you want to. You're dismissed. You can soak for a few minutes, or you can get up and leave where you want to. Praise God.